Welcome to It Happened in Grand Prairie, Texas. As we bring you the history of our city and some of the things that have happened in history and about the people that made this history and that they're still making history this very day, one day at a time in Grand Prairie, Texas. For history tape number 659, we're bringing to you something about keep Texas beautiful, keep Grand Prairie beautiful, keep the world beautiful, and we're just so pleased to have Her Majesty of Beautification in Grand Prairie, Texas, Tammy Chan, longtime supporter and authenticator of anything that happens in beautification, clean up, fix up, paint up, recycling, and a host of other words. Tammy, we're glad to have you back, my dear.
Thank you, Miss Ruthie. I'm so glad to be here.
Tammy Chan, it's really great to have a lady that has made herself so famous in Grand Prairie, Texas, that now she has an assistant. Isn't that good?
I'm blessed.
Yes. And Kaylee Shaw, I'm so pleased that you're here with us today, my dear.
Thank you.
As chairman of the Keep Grand Prairie Beautiful and other faculties. And yes. So we're going to really get a wonderful show from you today. What's happening, Tammy?
Well, we wanted to give you a little recap of our trip to Austin, where we were awarded an award of excellence from Keep Texas Beautiful.
How many is this for you?
Oh, 12.
12?
Yeah. I wish I could say it's 12 Governor's Community Achievement Award, because that's the one that has the money behind it. We're going to try again this year.
Good.
I will tell you, we won that award twice before, recently, and that was $355,000 that is being used to beautify Main Street.
And in Grand Prairie, Texas?
Yes, ma'am. Right now, you'll see the south side of Main Street across from the Uptown and down from 2nd to 2nd being remodeled by TxDOT with beautiful trees. There'll be a nice parking lot project, beautiful sidewalks. It'll be a better place for you to walk and enjoy yourself in Grand Prairie.
And my favorite, the parallel parking in front of those places, getting all of the trucks and everything that did in-head parking that stuck out into the thing and almost made us make bricks in that area.
Yeah, it's going to be more beautiful. It'll match the north side, and yes, that project cost just under $355,000, so the citizens of Grand Prairie are not paying for it. It's an award because volunteerism through Keep Grand Prairie Beautiful, we compete based on how many hours, how many trees we planted, how many minutes of cable television. Yes. So your show helps us a lot.
That is such good history, and it is not my show that does it. Tell them who really causes this thing to happen because of the wonderful coverage we have in between segments of my show. Anytime, anything, there's a minute or two. Who is the one that calls that?
Mr. Don Johnson.
Mr. Don Johnson.
Yes, he behind the scenes, really helps us with our award applications. We have to count minutes and column inches, so we wouldn't be able to even be eligible if it weren't for you and Mr. Johnson and shows like this where we get to talk about Keep Grand Prairie Beautiful.
And not only that, he has already logged and put on television that 25 years of working with Keep Texas Beautiful and the Don't Mess with Texas, he has the history of that, plays it twice a day, and it's wonderful. And he's the only one, as far as I know, that had privilege to get a copy of that from TDOT. They sent it to us, and he has used it to the hilt and used everything in between all of my shows. He picks and chooses the right thing to put in there. So I think we ought to give Don an award.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Johnson, for all you do.
Yes.
And I hope that with these extra efforts he's making and all our volunteers, that we'll win the award this year. I wasn't able to attend the conference in Austin in June. Kelly Shaw, our commission chairperson, stepped up to the plate, dropped everything she was doing, went for the entire conference, and I knew that she would attend every session.
Yes.
We actually even strategized a little bit, and she took notes. She made a report to the commission at their monthly meeting, and I asked her to join me today with you so she could tell you and your guests a little bit about the conference and what she learned.
All right. Kelly, you're first and center. How did you like Austin?
I love Austin. Austin is a very forward-thinking city, and so it's perfect that the conference was in Austin again this year. I went last year But this year was special because I got to represent not just Keep Grand Prairie Beautiful, but the whole city of Grand Prairie. So it was important to me, and I did love it. I learned a lot, and brought some ideas back that we can use. Just to mention one of them, there is a group called the Litter Force.
Yes.
You may have heard of this, where there are superheroes that can come into the schools and give a huge demonstration. Well, they're kind of hard to get.
Yeah.
So this year I went to the class that showed how one person, maybe me, I'm not sure yet, can go into the schools and give a presentation using masks and DVD, coloring books like the one I have here that you can give out to the kids, and it gets that message across grades 1 through 3. So that was just one thing that we may, you know, bring to Grand Prairie schools.
And I was so glad to find you there, because I knew that we had the best in Grand Prairie. If we didn't have Tammy, we had someone that was kinship to the all of the things that are happening. And as the chair of Keep Grand Prairie Beautiful, you've had a lot of wonderful experience. And and I know that Tammy was pleased that she made the choice that she did. I don't think you had anyone else that was primed enough to go and take your place, Tammy.
No, Kelly last year led our litter initiative, Get Tough on Litter. And just even listening, I can almost cry, but to think that there's people that really care about keeping Grand Prairie beautiful, picking up litter, preventing litter. I mean, this lady goes out on I-20 Frontage Road, I'm not supposed to say that, and picks up litter at Robinson Road. She cannot stand it. She's always sending me pictures. Here she is planning to go into the schools. You know, it takes an individual effort and a decision to be serious about litter, and this lady is a champion for litter prevention and cleanup in Grand Prairie.
Oh, that is wonderful.
Thank you very much. Thank you. And if I may say something about this lady, she is one of the hardest working people I've ever known.
Now,
and I'm glad that she's getting some notoriety today. Good notoriety. Good
next,
press.
Next, I want you two to talk about part of the history was the Parks Board Hall of Fame that was presented at the Uptown Theater. And I'll tell you one thing. Kelly and I were there in force. And I want you to know, Tammy, we really missed you. And how dare you go to the hospital?
Well, I'm all better now, so watch out.
All right.
Thank you for going for me. It was... I better let Kelly tell about it, because it was a huge honor.
Yes, it was a huge honor, and she went in nervous and got up there cool as a cucumber and handled it beautifully, because I was standing right there behind her. Go ahead, Kelly.
Well, thank you, and I did cry that night, actually, because Tammy deserved that more than anybody in the world. But I was very happy to represent. It was a huge crowd.
Oh, yes.
Yes, it was wonderful. And what we love about it is being recognized by a fellow department. That's extra special. So, yes, it was a tremendous honor. And I was happy to represent. I just had wished that Tammy could be there for that night. But it was a wonderful event. And Rick Harold, he's hilarious.
Isn't he fun?
He was a great MC for the whole thing, and it was good to see other people being honored as well. It was great.
I want to jump in and say that it really wasn't an award for me. It was an award for the Keep Grand Prairie Beautiful Commission.
And they were there, a lot of them.
Yes.
I believe
you
had five people there, didn't you?
Mm-hmm.
They really were, and I really commend the Parks Board and the Parks Department for setting up a program like the Hall of Fame. I wish Keep Grand Prairie Beautiful had thought of it. You know, we talked about our awards at our commission meeting the other day. We have so many different programs. We give different awards at a different time. But Hall of Fame from another commission, what an honor.
Yes. Well, that's wonderful. And we're so pleased that not only are you home from the hospital, but you're in good spirits and have been working like sin to get everything done on Main Street to keep everything getting ready for Christmas, right?
Yeah, I'm excited. We're, you know, our history for beautification has been very grassroots, you know, just pulling together what we can. We have a larger team with Amy Sprinkles and Rita Heap and other people working together. And I think each year Main Street will be more beautiful, but reasonably more beautiful. It's hard to go spend money on Christmas decorations when everybody's struggling so much, but it does bring joy and make everybody feel better. And our fall decorations will come up first. That's exciting.
What are the plans now for Keep Grand Prairie Beautiful? Since we've done the Hall of Fame, since we've been to Austin, since we've taken care of everything between June the 21st and whenever the Hall of Fame was held.
Let me interrupt 1 second.
Yes.
This is important, and I don't want to miss this. I need to tell your viewers what a rock star you are. Yes, ma'am. I saw Ruthie surrounded by people the whole time during the conference. I just want to tell you, everyone loves you so much. I just have to pass that on.
Well, thank
you.
You
are
very
a
much.
Star, definitely.
Well, thank you very much. Grand Prairie has been good to let me go and represent them on the side from Keep Grand Prairie Beautiful as an officer of that and a past president of the Keep Texas Beautiful, and it's been wonderful. But I have never featured myself as a rock star. I'm just an old granny in tennis shoes.
Well, you are, and I got to add something to that. I do have things to tell you about what's coming up, but on the history side of things, you know, a lot of people may not realize, but there's an award named after you in Austin that people all around the state compete all year to try to win, the Ruthie Jackson Youth Leadership Award. And every year with the youth, she pays $100 per youth for the award. I hope I'm okay telling them that. She saves the money out of her Social mm-hmm. Security, whatever way she can, to instill recognition in these young people and further their desire to do service, especially environmental. And so this year at the conference, Ruthie stepped up out of her own heart and sponsored another award in perpetuity for her friend Sadie Ray Graff, who an award was named for the educators who work with the youth. And for years, Ruthie supported that, but you've made it possible for that award to last forever. And your commitment to young people making a difference in the environment, them actually doing things, and the people who support them, you're the wind beneath their wings, Ruthie.
Well, I thank you very much, but we weren't supposed to get into that, but I thank you very much for even remembering any of those things. It's been wonderful to be a part of Keep Texas Beautiful since 1967, and that's back in the dark ages, so thank you very much. But now let's get on to this, what's happening right now that's important to us to do now so that when we go next time, we can come back with M-O-N-E-Y.
Okay. Well, you just can't imagine the schedule we have. It's very full, upcoming right away. Grand Prairie has a pretty large network of community gardens. We're getting a little bit famous for that.
Aren't we, though?
Yes, we are. We have five, you know, pretty large gardens, mm-hmm. and we have a waiting list of people who are interested in having a bed. It's all free, and we have lessons and everything. And so we're having an orientation for people who are interested. All the people who signed up at the farmer's market, I'll be contacting you, but other people who are listening today, if you want to learn about community garden or just garden at home, we have an orientation coming up at 3 p.m. on September 24th. That's a Saturday. Take about an hour and a half, and we'll tell you where our gardens are, where we have openings.
10 o'clock?
3 p.m.
3 p.m.
That's Saturday, the 24th, 3 p.m. Mm-hmm. at the Development Center, which is 206 West Church Street. And at that meeting, we'll hopefully fill any vacancies that we have, but we'll also let you know the future development of other gardens we're building. So I hope to, you know, come back on your show with some of our garden people. It's really an awesome thing.
Oh, yes. We need to do that.
Yeah. We suffered this summer, you know, with the heat, but everybody hand watered, you know, with the water restrictions we have. We have to hand water just like everybody else. And we had some successes. We had some plants that are a little charred, but nobody gave up.
That's right.
Yeah. And so our big event that we have every spring and fall is Trash Off. And we do that every year, Saturday in April and the first Saturday in October. And so October 1st is Trash Off, and a couple of things that means. All Adopt-A-Street groups, you're supposed to be going out picking up litter along your section of street, and we need you to turn in your post-cleanup report form because that's how we get our grant funds. That's so important. And we invite you to join us for a free lunch, again at the Development Center at 12 o'clock. We'll grill some dogs and hot dogs. I mean, we'll have some chips and things like that for you to come join us. We'll have a contest for the most unusual item found. So if you want to go out there, adopt street groups, and if you're listening, you just want to help pick up litter, you can call me and I'll give you my number at the end of the show and come and help us. And if you are doing a home cleanup project and you've got some things you need to get rid of, you can take them to the landfill as a resident unlimited on Saturday, October 1st. Just have to have your water bill with you. It's not for commercial, it's for residential. It's free as many times as you need to go in, except for the case of tires and computers. There's $1 each for those kind of things. Now, the landfill charges for you to bring your computers and other electronic waste. Well, guess what? Keep Grand Prairie Beautiful is going to offer you a free electronic waste collection.
Oh, when is that going to be?
And you can't find this anywhere because monitors are the killer. You know, they can cost up to $5 to dispose of. It's going to be at the City of Grand Prairie Development Center on November 19th. Now, November 15th is Texas America Recycles Day, and that's in the middle of the week.
Yeah.
We want everybody to have a chance to enjoy this event. So it's Saturday, November 19th from 9 to 2, again, at the Development Center. That's my office. And so you can just roll up. We have volunteers who will unload your car for you, and we'll have all these little boxes, and we'll mm-hmm. separate the waste, and all of that waste gets recycled.
Oh, good.
And it's free. So e-waste collection, even your old Game Boys, your old CDs, CD containers, you know, plastics like that, please bring it. That's Saturday, November 19th. November, yeah, 19th. Now, I skipped another date, Ms. Ruthie, that's really important. I'm getting a lot of calls on this.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh. With this summer heat that we've had, so many trees are suffering. They just need a lot more water than they're getting. And I see it all over the city. I see broken limbs. I see trees dying back. I see trees dying. So the city has a program for citizen foresters called the Shade Makers Citizen Forestry Program. And during that class, we will have quite a bit of talk about, you know, drought-stressed trees, what you can do about it, how to care for them, should you take them out, should you replace them, how to get a free quality tree. If you take our class, you can get a free, really nice tree, $139 value, to be planted in the public view. Like, you can't go plant it at Lake Texoma where your grandma has her ranch.
No.
I've had people ask that. You can plant it right here in Grand Prairie in your front yard. If you're part of a neighborhood association and you have a little space you want to plant, we mm-hmm. can work together to plan that. And a representative mm-hmm. from your group can yes. come and get three free mm-hmm. trees for a planting project. As a matter of fact, mm-hmm. Westchester Haven is going to send mm-hmm. representatives to take the class and do just that. Mm-hmm. It's taught by certified arborists, and we will provide you with meals during the class and a free pruning tool, as well as a book that's dedicated to our soils mm-hmm. and trees from our area. Mm-hmm. Youth are invited to. We have a junior shade maker program as well. So come mm-hmm. come with your parents, bring them, and get some free trees.
For those that have lost trees during this, this time, is there going to be a plan where we can cut the trees down and move it out to the curb, or are we going to have to wait for a signal from you, or what?
Well, trees are a private matter, and our Shade Maker program is the city's effort to try to come yeah. to the middle and help you with tree planting. We have citizen foresters that we've trained to properly trim and prune and even remove trees that qualify. And what that means is if you are on a fixed income as a senior citizen yes. or uh-huh. disabled resident, and you have a tree that the limb is, you know, split and it's yeah. you know, about to fall on your carport, we'll send out, I go out, I'm an arborist, and I'll evaluate. If it's something that our volunteer foresters can do with the equipment we loan, they'll come out and, you know, trim that for you.
But we're all on our own for the trees now.
Yeah, for the big trees, you know, let's say you have an ash tree between the curb and the sidewalk. A lot of people in the northeast yes. area have that. If that tree is dead, that tree actually belongs to the resident. A lot of people think it belongs to the yes. city, but it's the resident. Same thing for trees in the alley, that belongs to the resident. And so a lot
we
of
we have one more minute till we get to 20.
Okay. They're asking for the city to come and do it. We don't have a crew that goes and takes care of those trees,
good.
But I can give you some good recommendations.
Good.
So at the end, I'll tell you. But that Shade Makers class
you're is... You're nice. You're Shade Makers class is?
October 28th, 29th, and 30th. The 28th, it's 6 to 9. The 29th, it's 10 to 4. And the 30th, it's 2 to 6, and we'll do a project.
And that's the time?
That's the date.
I have the date. You have the time.
Yeah, the time. 6 to 9 on Friday, 10 to 4 on Saturday, and 2 to 6 on Sunday the 30th. You do need to register for that.
Okay.
And when you give me a chance, I'll give my number.
We'll do that. Okay. That sounds wonderful. You sure have lots of good things going for Grand Prairie, Texas.
We sure do.
Yes. And it's 20. And with your permission, may I let you all rest a minute and you all think up something real good to say if I can get through with my announcement in a hurry. Thank you.
You got it.
We have a special salute announcement today. As you can see that I have clean it and green it. This comes from MOULTON Texas, who went to the Keep Texas Beautiful meeting, and they won the governor's award because they have only less than 3,000 members in their whole town. They're in the county seat of Hallettsville in Lavaca County, which is down near the coast, and we want to thank Kathy Ritterhouse for putting us to where they are, and thank Mr. Johnson for taking the messages. He's a message taker also. This Moulton, Texas, and their green t-shirt came to us because we did a salute to them when we were in Austin, and this is part of our history. We stopped by their booth and told them they had a wonderful, wonderful display, and for a town as small as less than 3,000, we gave them the salute. And they, because we did all of that, they gave a big amount of money to the youth thing. They gave me this shirt. They gave me a whole catalog of things that happened to them in their work, and I want to salute Moulton, Texas. And we do have a photograph of this, and when Miss Amy gets back, we're going to be able to get Mr. Johnson a picture of this group. And thank you for saluting Moulton, Texas. And it was really, really wonderful because they said, Miss Jackson, you're the only person that's an officer in this thing that ever came by and congratulated us and stayed with us and took pictures. So we salute them for doing that for us. And we'll thank Amy for getting that picture to Mr. Johnson with all of their pictures in it at their booth in Austin, Texas. And that was on the 24th day, which was about the last day that we were in Austin. And thank you all for being here and letting us salute a very special group. And we do have about probably 2 minutes more that we could talk a little bit about you all and what you have meant to Grand Prairie, especially this year when by disasters or whatever happened or dust storms or fires, we didn't have Tammy in Austin and we didn't have Tammy at this wonderful Hall of Fame thing. And so now we have a new star in the taking. And we're just so pleased for Kelly Shaw that you brought her today.
Yeah, and Kelly is a wonderful asset to our program. She's an artist, and she's done several things to help keep Grand Prairie beautiful with our visibility. And one of the things she's wearing it now, she crafts jewelry, handmade jewelry, and she sells that, and a percentage of it goes back into Keep Grand Prairie Beautiful. So she recently gave me a check for $90.
Oh, good.
To help further our causes. So she's... You couldn't ask for a better commissioner.
Yes, yes.
Yep.
Is there anything really special you're going to do between now and the end of this year when that's the cutoff date so we can just cinch the governor's award? Just think about it coming our way next year.
I think the biggest thing volunteer-wise, I have two big ones, but October 15th is our big creek cleanup day.
Creek cleanup.
And we're sending people out in kayaks and canoes and mini barges, and we're going to paddle down Kirby and Fish Creek and go out to where that big wetland is, where
yes.
the Beltline Bridge
yes.
crosses Fish Creek. And we do a huge job of that every year, and I've got more and more volunteers and North Texas River Runners and a couple of Girl Scout troops and Boy Scouts interested. I'm running out of boats, and that's a good problem. But
yes.
there's still space. If somebody would like to come out on the water and help us, we'll be working from 9 to 2, and there's a lunch in that. We'll paddle down. It takes about 30, 40 minutes to get to the cleanup site. And we don't paddle all that trash back, Miss Ruthie.
No.
We station people on the bridge. We close off the road, and we hang hammocks like you sleep in over the edge of the bridge, and the volunteers who are at the trash area load the hammocks and we pull it up and then we haul it off to the landfill.
Good.
And so on October 15th, if you see commotion on the bridge on Beltline, underneath that bridge there's a bunch of volunteers picking up floatables, making Grand Prairie cleaner and more beautiful.
More beautiful. All right. You have only a half a minute to tell anything you want to tell and to thank Kelly for being here today and for doing us all of our jobs for us.
Okay, my phone number is important, 972-237-8152, or you can email me at KGPB, like Key Grand Prairie Beautiful, at gptx.org.
Good.
And Miss Kelly, we're so thankful for you being on the commission, and I hope that you'll put your name in the hat again when your time is close to expiring.
Mm-hmm. I certainly will. This is a passion for me, and I'm honored and proud to be a part of it.
That's wonderful. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
For being a genius, and thank you for
thank
being
you.
An assistant genius.
Thank you.
We needed both of you in all of these things, and just remember that history is as we live and do, and that we document it as well as we can to be truthful and factual and in favor of Grand Prairie, Texas. Thank you for watching our history show number 659, and God bless America and God bless Grand Prairie.